Hola everyone, Christian here. In the past, we've mentioned size charts and how important they are for your product page. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add different size charts depending on your product without any apps. So let's get started. Now, a big portion of e-commerce returns happen when products don't match their online descriptions, and size charts are an essential part of that e-commerce customer experience. So let me show you how to add them to your product page. But before we do that, actually, I want to show you the final product and how we're going to add size charts to this particular store right here. Now, just warning before this, I'm adding this to the Dawn theme. So that's what we're gonna be using for this example. And as you can see here, this is a product page. We're under one of our dummy stores, Shibby's Boutique. You have the product page in here, and then when we scroll down a little bit, you'll see the size chart in a collapsible menu. When you click on it, you'll see the image in there showing you the actual dimensions of that particular garment. Now, there are different ways on how to add a size chart to your product page, and the reason why I chose this one is because you're able to showcase different size charts depending on the product, and that's what we're looking for here. So we don't have like six different size charts in here, and I didn't want to have necessarily a link, right, where they have to click and go somewhere else, and also didn't want to showcase a size chart inside of the product description, because sometimes that product description can be very, very lengthy, and I didn't want to add to the length of the actual page. So that's why we chose to do it this way. Now, I do want to show you in this example, we're going to be going over adding these two different size charts. I just kind of got these from Google, but just an example, let's pretend like the one on the left is going to be for shirts and the one on the right is going to be for dresses. Now, before we go into Shopify, I just want to say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Piñon, one of the co-founders here at Bit Branding. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. We drop new videos every week, so make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out. All right, so for this example, we're actually gonna use a combination of different things. We are going to use the new meta fields, and we're gonna use pages, and we're gonna use, again, like I said, the Dawn theme. So first thing that we wanna do here is go to settings. And then inside of settings, you scroll all the way down and you go to meta fields. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna add the meta field of size chart. Add definition. And this one, we're gonna do the shirt size chart. So let's do, let's the name it size chart. Because that will be taken care of when we actually select them. So we're gonna do size chart in there. Again, description is optional. It's for internal purposes only. We're gonna click on select content type. And then in here, what we're going to do is do a reference. So the reference is going to be a page. So all we're doing here is basically having a sort of a drop down inside of the product page so you can actually select different pages. And then we're gonna go to the pages and create the shirt and then the dresses size chart in there. So now that we created this, I'm gonna click save on that. And let me show you how that looks here inside of the product page. So we scroll all the way down, you'll see the meta fields, you'll see size chart in here. When we click on that, we have the option to select a page. So this will show you just all the pages that we have internally right here within the site. But we haven't added the actual images into those pages. So what we're gonna do is click online store, go to pages. And then in here, we're gonna add page. And this one, we're gonna call it shirt size chart. Then in here, we're gonna do insert image. We already have the image in here. I'm actually gonna do just original size, insert image, save. And then I'm going to add another page. And that one's gonna be, let's say, the dresses. Insert image, upload file. Select that. Again, I'm gonna do original size, insert image, and then I'm gonna click on save. Let's go back to see all pages. And now we see that we have a dresses size chart and a shirt size chart. All right, so after we have those set up, all we have to do is go back to products, go to the actual product that you want to display a size chart. And we click on that, select page. Let's say for this one, this is a shirt. So we click on the shirt one. So that means that for this product, we're gonna have this specific size chart in here. Save that. And then let's go to this other product. See, this example actually had this size chart already included within the description. Let me get rid of that. Okay. And let's pretend that this is a dress. And then under size chart, select page. And we're gonna do the dresses. Hey, before we continue, I just wanna say, if you like what you see, please consider hitting that like button. All right, so now that we have everything set up, the next step is to actually go to the online store theme customizer and see how we can set up the actual size chart to show up in the product page. So we're gonna click on online store, theme, and then for this particular example, like I said, we're doing this updated copy of Dawn. So I click on customize. That will take it to the Shibi's boutique. Click right here, go to products, default product. And then right within here, you'll see that it's actually already in here. So I've been adding it for a different example, but I'm gonna click on the eyeball there so we can actually add it. So what you'll wanna do is inside of product information, there's a dropdown, click on that, and you'll see all the different elements for the actual product page and the product information side of things. So you'll see that the title, the price, the quantity selector, all that stuff. Now we're gonna click on add a block. Then in here, you wanna do collapsible row. It might be named something different depending on the version of Dawn that you have. We do have the 4.0 version, and I think that's the latest one as of right now. So add the collapsible row. And that's just gonna be that accordion, type section. And then when we click on it, we can give it a heading. So we can call it size chart. All right, and then the icon, we can change that to, let's see, maybe pants. Let's do shirt. I feel like shirt might be more universal. Yeah, I like that. So size chart, and then the row content, and then row content per front page. What we're going to do, and I tried doing different things in here. So if you have a different type of size chart, maybe you don't have an image, maybe you have more text-based. So the actual dynamic source, right, is going to be those meta fields. You can do a different meta field. So the meta field that we did originally was the reference. You could potentially try something like a text or something else in order to display that size chart. But for this one, we did the image and we did it inside of a page. So we're gonna do row content from page. Now, you could do just select the page, but this will essentially be for every single product. It will have the exact same size chart. So we wanna create a sort of dynamic source. So connect a dynamic source. And that's what we're gonna do here. And as you can see, the dynamic source will show up right here. So that's one of the meta fields. If you haven't done this step yet, you'll see that you'll have the link right here to add meta fields. That'll take you to the very beginning of our video where we're creating that. So click on size chart in there, click connect. Now, before I do that, now more than ever, you need to be able to see your blind spots and opportunities in your clothing store. So that's why we found software called Triple Whale. And this will literally put all the data points that you need to know about your business into one place so that every single day you can see your opportunities, your net profit, growth, everything combined with different sources, right? Facebook, Shopify, Klaviyo, all into one platform, one single location. That way it will allow you to grow profitably, continue to grow profitably. So check that out in the description below. Now that we have everything set up here, let me show you how this looks. Again, click on the preview link here. Let's go to that product that we set it up here for. And as we can see, click on size chart and it looks like we have the right one showing up right here. That looks awesome. And then let's check out the other product that we had set, which I think it was none of those. Let me go back here and check this out as far as the product. I think it was the, Bite the Bullet. Let's see if we can click on preview for that. course, the pop-up is blocked. Yeah, there we go. Oh, it's showing me the wrong preview. So, do manage online store. There we go. Save. All right, that should do it. So let me refresh this page. There's the product. And then if we look at this size chart, we see the other size chart that we actually updated as a different page. So there you have it. Now we have two different size charts for two different products, and it all happens dynamically in the back end, where you actually go in to select right here the actual page that you want located for that. Now, this is not just for size charts. You could use the same method for anything else that you want to display right within your product page that will be dynamic. So it will be different on a per page basis. So think about, a lot of people do, and we do recommend, a lot of people do the model info for that particular product, right? So you can actually have different pages with the model info for each of those models that you have displayed on your store. And you can select the model right within here. So to actually display the right information for that product and not have a full list of all the models that you use for your store. Now, we often don't talk about this, but if you already have a Shopify store and you've already launched this store into the interwebs, then I would highly suggest that you check out the website after launch. This is sort of a mini course that we created that helps you navigate the world after you publish your site, right? After you hit that publish button, what happens next? You know, what are those next steps? And also, we give you actionable things that you need to be doing on a weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly basis for your store to stay up to date and high conversions. That's a crazy thing that everyone keeps talking about, but it's super important to keep up with high conversions, and this mini course will help you achieve that. So check it out in the description below.